Hi everyone, Lloyd Rieber here again at my home on Nowhere Road in Madison County, Georgia. I'm here down at our barn to check on our animals. We have two Jersey cows, Annabelle and Bluebell. We have some sheep, a lot of chickens. We even have a donkey named Lester. I'd like to describe the course, Statistics and Education for Mere Mortals, in a little more detail to give you a sense of what to expect and how to manage your time. The course is divided into four modules or units. Welcome and orientation, descriptive statistics, correlational statistics, and inferential statistics. At this point, I have to say the obvious. This short course is not a substitute for a full curriculum on statistics. Our goal is to get familiar with some of the most fundamental concepts of statistics, mainly by conquering their computation. The structure of each module is similar. I'll provide one or two short presentations to introduce or explain the module's concepts and principles. Then we'll move on into Excel, where I will demonstrate how to compute a statistical procedure from scratch. That is, we will do the computation basically by hand, but also taking full advantage of Excel. We'll set up and define the calculations needed, but we'll let Excel do all of the tedious, hard work of actually performing the calculations. For example, we might need to enter a long column of test scores that must be added up, but we'll actually have Excel do the calculation of summing. We will deliberately avoid using any of Excel's built-in statistical functions, which are many, until we have finished doing our own calculations. Then we'll use Excel's stat functions to check our work. Remember, our goal is to understand where all the calculated numbers and statistics come from. Getting the answer is not the point. Knowing how to get to the answer is. I have recorded and described each and every Excel step so you can watch each recording as often as you like, pausing and rewinding as you wish as you build your own Excel spreadsheet. I cannot emphasize strongly enough the importance of this hands-on activity. It is the cornerstone activity of the entire course. So you must resist the temptation to hurry as you build your spreadsheet. If you take your time and relax, I know you can be successful. I've used this technique in my own teaching of statistics at the University of Georgia, and I have yet to have a single student who tried fail to succeed. When you are done building your spreadsheet, your answers, of course, should match mine, and you know the ones I have in the video. But then I'll send everyone a new set of data to enter. All you will need to do is copy and paste the new data into your spreadsheet, the one that you just built. Then you'll be asked to submit some of the resulting statistics as an evaluation just by copying and pasting from your spreadsheet into a web form. This will probably take about 5 minutes depending on how fast you can copy and paste. If your answers are correct, you earn a badge for that module. If they're not, you can try again as many times as you wish. To pass the course and to earn a certificate of completion, you need to complete all of the modules successfully and pass a final exam. The final exam will cover a range of learning, including facts, concepts, and application. Again, you can take this final exam as often as you like until you pass it. Of course, we all make mistakes and get confused occasionally, so I've set up some discussion boards for you to get help, mainly from your classmates. We are expecting a large enrollment, so it's important that you look to your classmates first for help and support. But I'll be monitoring things very closely, and I'll jump in to help straighten things out as needed. So, I hope this gives you a good idea of how the course is structured. I also hope you can see that our emphasis here is on learning statistics by doing statistics. Although, again, this short course should not be mistaken for a full statistics curriculum. It will give you a good overview of some of the most fundamental and useful statistics. Many educational professionals can begin using these ideas and tools immediately as part of their evaluation work. And first-year doctoral students should feel ready, able, and willing to tackle their statistical coursework. And this course will give everyone a powerful study technique using Excel that you can use for learning other statistical ideas. So how about we dive right into it? All right, well, I'm going to get back to my animals. See you later.